Hi everyone. In this session, we are going to discuss about kinetic energy. Last session, we studied a kind of mechanical energy, that is potential energy. Kinetic energy is the second kind of mechanical energy. What is kinetic energy? The energy possessed by a body due to its motion or movement is known as kinetic energy. Okay. So just consider that you are going to throw a stone on the window glass. Mostly what's going to happen? That glass is going to break it. How it happened? Initially the stone was at rest. So when you applied a work on that, it stored that work in the form of energy, right? And it started moving. When we throw it, it started. That is the way how we are applying the work. So our work stored in the form of energy, with that energy, when it hit on the glass, it got break. Okay. So, all the body, due to this motion, it always possesses an energy. That energy, we used to call it as kinetic energy. Let's see the factors which are affecting the kinetic energy. Mainly, there are two factors which affect the kinetic energy. First one, mass of the body. Okay, mass of the body is the first factor. As the mass increases, the kinetic energy also increases. Or we can tell that mass is directly proportional to kinetic energy. And the second factor is the speed, how much speed the object is moving. Speed of the object. Okay. So, we used to represent with the letter V. And V is also directly proportional to kinetic energy. Okay. So, these are the factors which affect the kinetic energy, mass and speed. Speed is actually the square of the speed is directly proportional to the kinetic energy. Now, we'll see the expression for kinetic energy. Consider that if a body of mass m moving with a speed of v, the kinetic energy is equal to half m v square. Okay, half into m into v square. So by applying, by substituting the value in this equation, we can find out the kinetic energy of a moving body. Now what is the unit of kinetic energy? The SI unit of kinetic energy is also joule. So all the energy we used to represent with the SI unit joule. Now we'll see the differences between kinetic energy and potential energy. So kinetic energy and potential energy. First one, what's the first difference? It is due to the motion. Right? No? Energy possessed by a body due to the motion. This one, it's due to the position or rest. Right? Now it's due to the position or rest. Now second one, here as in the case of kinetic energy, the work done on moving object. We are doing the work done for making the object to move. Here we are doing the work done to bring to the rest position. Okay. Third important one, kinetic energy can be converted into any form. It can be converted into any form. But there is a specialty for potential energy. If you want to convert potential energy, only we have to convert it into kinetic energy. After coming to kinetic energy only, it can again convert into another form. So potential energy can be first converted into kinetic energy. There is no other form is possible. But kinetic energy can be converted into any form. So keep this in your mind. We studied the law of conservation. What's law of conservation? Energy can neither be created nor destroyed. Only it can transform from one form to another form. Same way, when we discuss about the mechanical energy, we studied that mechanical energy is the sum of kinetic energy and potential energy. So, the entire energy is conserved. Okay. So, here in this session, we are going to discuss about how potential energy is converting into kinetic energy when it is in use. Okay, few examples we'll see. First one, consider the case of the water stored in the dam or hydroelectric power station. Okay, so what is the major or main source of hydroelectricity? The water stored in the dam, right? So when the water stored in the dam, which kind of energy it possesses? It possesses potential energy, right? No? Okay, so that water through a pipe we used to collect it to the power station. So what happens when the water started moving? That stored potential energy is converting into kinetic energy, right? And what we are doing with the water? We will allow the water to fall upon a turbine, then the turbine will rotate, right? No? Till that time kinetic energy is working. Then when the turbine rotates, what happens? That is converting it into electrical energy, right? First stored in the dam, it has potential energy, it converted into kinetic energy, then finally it converted it into electrical energy. Okay, first case, dam. So stored energy is potential energy. Initially the first conversion is kinetic energy. Okay, then second one, consider you have a timepiece with you. Every morning you want to get up. Instead of mobile, I know that all will be using the mobile, you just forget about the mobile, the normal timepiece. How you used to keep the alarm? We used to rotate the key, right? No? Okay, we used to place the at their particular position. So when the time of 5 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 6 o'clock or 8 o'clock, the alarm will start working. So when we arrange it, actually we winded the spring inside that. So when we wind the spring, what happens? It stores energy. Which kind of energy? Elastic potential energy. Okay, that's also potential energy. When the alarm start ringing, what happens? This winding is getting loose, or it have the winding is having the movement. So that's why the alarm start ringing. So there also it converting it into kinetic energy. Okay, last class I showed with the rubber band. When we stretch the rubber band and keep a paper and leaf, what happens? That paper will move forward. Or consider the case of bow and arrow. Okay, when we stretch the bow, it possesses potential energy, right? Then in which form it converts? It initially, when we leave the arrow, what happens? That potential energy is given to the arrow and it start moving. So how it is converting? It converting it into kinetic energy, right? No? Now we'll see the case of a falling ball. Okay, just consider you have a ball at a particular position and you're going to drop it. So this is the ground. Okay, so at this position, which kind of energy it possesses? It possesses maximum potential energy. Slowly you drop the ball, so it started falling to the ground. Now this is the position of the ball. Okay, which kind of energy it possesses? This is above the ground, so it possesses potential energy and at the same time it is moving. So potential energy plus kinetic energy. Okay, so according to the size or the position got changed, so the potential energy reduced. So how much it reduced? That is converted into kinetic energy for the moment. When it comes here, again it possesses, it reduces its potential energy and kinetic energy is increased. When it reaches this position or just before the hitting the ground, potential energy is going to be zero and kinetic energy will be maximum. Okay, this is the way how potential energy is converting into kinetic energy as in the case of falling ball. Now we'll see the swinging of a pendulum. Do you know what is pendulum, pendulum, clock? one only the top will be fixed and the other end will be moving like this way. Or just consider the swing, the movement of a swing. Okay, so this position is fixed and now this is the normal position. Okay, the swing is at here. I'm just marking with a ball. Okay, now which kind of energy it possesses? This is at rest. Okay, now slowly it starts moving to this side. Consider this as A. Okay, now the ball position is here. When it start moving, now this is potential energy or at rest. Now when it start moving, it possesses kinetic energy. When it come to this position maximum, the potential energy will be maximum. It is at a particular height from the ground. Okay, so here the potential energy is zero initially. Then when it start moving to one end at a maximum height, it possesses potential energy. And in between, it possesses kinetic energy because it start moving. Then it start moving. So that potential energy is converting it into kinetic energy, and finally it reaches at the another point, same point C. It also possesses maximum potential energy. And when this is moving, it has maximum kinetic energy at this position and maximum potential energy on either position. Each and every position, kinetic energy, potential energy is converting it into kinetic energy or vice versa. Okay, let's see the case of roller coaster. Let's consider these are the three different positions of a roller coaster. Okay, now at A, the object is going to start. So that is at rest. So it is above from the ground. So which kind of energy it possesses? It possesses potential energy. Okay, I'm going to write it as E. At this time, it is at rest, so kinetic energy is zero. When it start moving, this potential energy is slowly converting it into kinetic energy. When it reaches the ground level, potential energy is going to be zero and kinetic energy will be maximum. Okay, now it is at a position C. It's not too much height comparing with A. It is little bit less than the height of A. So at this time, it possesses kinetic energy. It possesses potential energy plus kinetic energy will be equal to E minus potential energy because it reduces the height. Okay, so if we see the conservation of energy, we can tell that at each position, total energy is always conserved. Okay, total energy is always conserved in all the three positions. If we take the sum, potential energy plus kinetic energy will be equal to E. Thank you.